Hello and welcome to today's video. If you've had a tooth out, it's very important for you to take care of the extraction site in order to prevent complications. Let's look at the do's and don'ts that one needs to follow in order to aid the healing process. Immediately after you've had your tooth removed, bite down onto the piece of gauze that's given to you by your dentist for at least 20 minutes. This pressure pack will stop the bleeding. Now, if the bleeding continues after this, bite down onto a fresh piece of gauze for further 20 minutes. Before removing a tooth, your dentist will usually numb the area. Now, the local anesthetic given will take a couple of hours or sometimes even longer to wear out completely. So, as the anesthesia wears out, be careful not to chew the insides of your cheek or bite your tongue, as you could end up doing a lot of damage to these tissues. Let's look at what you need to be doing in the first 24 hours. Now, when a tooth is removed, a clot usually forms at the extraction site. Now, it's very important for this clot to stay in place. Now, if you rinse or spit out, then this clot can get dislodged and then it leads to further complications. So, for the first 24 hours, make sure that you do not spit out. There may be blood or saliva pooling in the mouth. If that's the case, just swallow the blood or swallow the saliva. You can expect slight amount of bleeding or swelling in the first 24 to 48 hours. This is considered as normal body reaction. Avoid using a straw to have your drink. Instead, just sip from a cup directly. Do not smoke for at least 48 hours. If possible, try and avoid smoking for a week. It's best to avoid hot drinks such as hot tea or coffee on the first day. Instead, you could choose options such as ice cold water, milkshake, squash, etc. Make sure you avoid any sort of strenuous physical activity because this can dislodge the clot. And if your workplace demands that you lift heavy objects, it's best to take the first day off if possible. You can take over-the-counter painkillers for pain relief, and you can take a painkiller about an hour or two after the procedure because that's when the anesthesia will start to wear out and the pain may start to kick in. Make sure you do not play with the extraction site, especially with your tongue, or disturb the clot while you're brushing. It's very important to keep the site clean and leave it as undisturbed as possible. One of the most common questions that we get asked is, what about food and drink and when can I eat? Now, it's best not to eat anything the first half an hour after the procedure because that's when you should be focusing on maintaining pressure and getting the bleeding to stop. After that, it's advised to have plenty of fluids such as water, and this will help replenish lost fluids from the body. Avoid fluids such as alcohol or caffeinated drinks, carbonated beverages, and hot drinks in the first 24 hours. So let's answer the next big question. When can you eat? Now, you can eat 30 to 40 minutes after the procedure. That is when the bleeding is under control. Now, if your dentist has given you an anesthetic that has numbed even your cheeks as well as your lips or even your tongue, then it's best to wait till the anesthesia wears out and then eat. Because if you eat with numb tissues, you may just end up damaging these tissues. Try and consume soft foods for the first 48 hours, such as mashed potato, soup, yogurt, ice cream, or anything cold will also help. Avoid spicy food and sharp food such as crisps for the first 3 to 4 days, as this can irritate the area and impede healing. Here are a few more tips that will aid healing. So after the first 24 hours, you can gently rinse your mouth with warm salty water. So do this about 3 to 4 times daily, and you can do this for a week, and this will keep the area clean and also will prevent further infection. Now, the extraction site will usually take a week to 10 days to heal, but the complete bone formation may take up to 4 to 5 months. While sleeping, it's best to sleep on your back with your head raised. Try and avoid sleeping on your sides, as this may increase the pressure on the extraction site. Do not directly brush the extraction site for 3 to 4 days. If any food is lodged, gently rinse that area with warm salt water. In some cases, you might find that your dentist may place a few stitches in that area. Now, if that's the case, they usually will dissolve in about 10 days' time and there's nothing to worry about. But occasionally, your dentist may use a different material known as a non-resorbable material. In such cases, you may have to go back to the dental office for the stitch to be removed. Usually, the dental assistant will fix an appointment for the same. Sometimes there might be a slight unpleasant smell from the extraction site, especially the first 3 to 4 days. Now, this is because of the bleeding from the extraction site. Now, if this is the case, then you can take few sips of lemon-infused water to freshen your breath. If you follow all the aftercare instructions that we've discussed, you should not have any issues with the healing of the extraction site. But sometimes, due to your medical history or due to other local factors, there can be complications. So let's look at the various scenarios in which you need to seek immediate expert help. Number one is profuse bleeding. If you're unable to control the bleeding and if you've placed a number of pressure packs and the bleeding is just not stopping, then try and seek help immediately. Number two is discharge. Now, if there's any discharge from the extraction site, then it could be a sign of infection and it's best to get it checked out by your dentist. Number three is foul smell. Slight unpleasant smell is expected the first few days because of the bleeding. Now, after day 3 and 4, if the smell is getting worse, then it's best to seek help. Number four is severe pain, which cannot be controlled by painkillers. Now, if you've been on painkillers for over 2 or 3 days and the pain is just getting worse, then try and see your dentist as soon as possible. Number five is increased swelling. Now, slight swelling will be there for the first 24 to 48 hours as this is the body's normal reaction. But post this period, if the swelling is getting bigger, then seek help. Hope you found this video useful. I wish you a speedy recovery and we'll see you soon in the next video.